Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to install OpenMediaVault onto your Raspberry Pi. OpenMediaVault is a software that allows you to turn your Raspberry Pi into a NAS. It gives you a web interface that allows you to easily set up new shared folders and configure network services such as Samba. It is one of the best solutions for turning your Raspberry Pi into a NAS without having to manually configure Samba shares and mount drives. For this tutorial, you will need to be running Raspberry Pi OS Lite. Additionally, you will need to be running at least a Raspberry Pi 2. Obviously, the newer the Raspberry Pi, the better performance you'll get with this software. For our video, we will be running this on a Raspberry Pi 5. No matter which direction you go, there are two things you will need before you even get started. First, you'll want an Ethernet connection to your Raspberry Pi. While you can technically use Wi-Fi with OpenMediaVault, you can only set that up after you've installed the software. Secondly, you will need a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi. The best way to achieve this is through DHCP reservation on your router. Once you're ready to go, connect to your Raspberry Pi using SSH or use the terminal directly. Once connected, the first thing you'll want to do is update the package list by typing sudo apt update. Next, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing sudo apt upgrade-y. Once the upgrade completes, we need to ensure wget is installed by typing sudo apt install wget. We will be using wget to grab and run the install script for OpenMediaVault on our Raspberry Pi. First, we must run the pre-install script by typing wget space hyphen capital O space hyphen space https colon symbol forward slash raw.githubusercontent.com/ OpenMediaVault hyphen plugin hyphen developers / install script / master / pre-install followed by space the pipe symbol then sudo space bash. This script will basically set our Ethernet connection so that it is persistent. This helps prevent connectivity issues later on. We now will want to restart our Raspberry Pi by typing sudo reboot. Once your Raspberry Pi finishes rebooting, we can now run the OpenMediaVault install script. Run this script by typing wget hyphen capital O space hyphen space https colon / raw.githubusercontent.com/ OpenMediaVault hyphen plugin hyphen developers / install script / master / install followed by the pipe symbol then sudo bash. This script will take a fair while to complete, so now is a good time to take a break. Once the script finishes installing OpenMediaVault onto your Raspberry Pi, it will automatically restart your system after a minute. Once your Pi finishes restarting, you have successfully installed OpenMediaVault. Our next step is to load up the web interface to finish configuring the software, as well as create some initial shares. If you've forgotten what your local IP address is for your Raspberry Pi, type in hostname space hyphen I. You can see that our local IP address is 192.168.0.32. Now, in your favorite web browser, go to http://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. You'll now be greeted by the login screen for OpenMediaVault. Here, you'll want to use the username admin and the password OpenMediaVault. Don't worry about this password, as we will be updating it shortly. Now, let's secure OpenMediaVault a little bit by changing the default password away from OpenMediaVault. To do this, click the user icon in the top right corner and then click change password. On this screen, specify a new password for your admin account. Ensure this password is secure, as the admin user has full control over OpenMediaVault. One thing you may have noticed when launching OpenMediaVault is that the dashboard is completely empty. Let's return to the dashboard so that we can add some widgets to it by clicking dashboard in the sidebar. Now on this page, click the settings page link. You can now enable some widgets that will give you a good quick overview of your Raspberry Pi and any file systems that you attach to it. Once you have enabled all the widgets you want to use, click the Save button at the bottom of the page. With that done, we can now move on to setting your Raspberry Pi up as a NAS using OpenMediaVault. The first part of this process is to attach a disk so that OpenMediaVault can start setting up shared folders. To start this process, click Storage in the sidebar and then click the Disks option. On this page, you'll see all the disks that OpenMediaVault can see that are attached to your Raspberry Pi. In our case, you can see that we have attached an 128GB USB drive to our Pi. If this drive isn't ready for using, you can use this interface to wipe it. You can also edit details about the drive directly in OpenMediaVault. As we have already wiped our drive, we will now change to the File Systems page by clicking File Systems in the sidebar. On this page, we can either mount an existing file system or create a new one on one of your attached disks. For this guide, we will be assuming that you are setting up a new disk, so we'll be clicking the plus symbol to begin creating a new file system. If you already have a drive set up, click the play button instead and skip the next step. Upon clicking the Create File System button, you'll be asked to select a file system type. For most users, ext4 will be good enough and not put too much pressure on the Raspberry Pi's relatively weak CPU. On this next page, you want to use the Device Select box to select the disk that you want to create this file system on. In our case, that is the 128GB USB drive we have plugged into our Raspberry Pi. Once you have a drive selected, click the Save button to begin creating the file system. Depending on the size of the drive, this process may take a minute or two. Once done, click the Close button. You'll now be taken to the Mount screen where we can mount the file system that you just created. Do this by clicking File System, then selecting the file system you just created. Within this screen, you can also select the Usage Warning Threshold. By setting this to 85%, OpenMediaVault will warn you once 85% of the drive has been consumed. Once done, click the Save button. Before OpenMediaVault will actually mount this drive, you need to confirm the change by clicking the tick button and then clicking yes. Our next step is to create a shared folder within our new drive. We can start this process by clicking Shared Folders in the sidebar. One thing to note that the shared folders we are creating now are just the physical location on your drive. For these to be able to be connected to, we will need to then share them again through the SMB service. Now on the screen, click the Create button to create your first shared folder. Let's start by giving this new share a name. In our case, we'll be calling ours My Raspberry Pi NAS Share. This name cannot contain any spaces and the use of symbols is not recommended. Next, we must select the file system that this share will be created on. Do this by clicking the File System Select box and then select the correct file system. By default, OpenMediaVault will use the share name as the folder name. You can change this if you like. Next, you can also adjust the permissions for this shared folder. By default, only admin and users can write to these shared folders. Once you're done, click the Save button. You now need to confirm the addition of this new share by clicking the Apply button and then clicking Yes. With the share created, our next step is to make it actually accessible from other devices. To do this, you'll be setting up SMB and adding it as a Samba share. To do this, click Services in the sidebar. Next, click SMB/CIFS. Before setting up the share, we must enable SMB by clicking the Settings option. On this page, tick the Enabled option at the top of the page and then scroll down and click the Save button. Like with any other change in OpenMediaVault, we must click the Apply button and then click Yes. We can now finally move on to setting up our first NAS share by clicking Shares in the sidebar. On this page, click the plus button to add a new share to the SMB. Now click the Shared Folder Select box and select the folder that you want to share. Now you can write a short comment to describe this share. In our case, we'll just call ours My Raspberry Pi NAS Share. The next important option on here is whether you want this share to be public or not. A public share can be accessed by guest accounts, whereas a private one will require you to log in to be able to view the folder's content. The other option here you may be interested in is whether this is a read-only share. By setting it to read-only, users can only read files from this folder. Once you're done configuring this share, click the Save button. We will now need to confirm this change again by clicking Apply and then Yes. You have now created your first network share using OpenMediaVault on your Raspberry Pi. Now before we mount this share, let us show you how you can create users directly through the OpenMediaVault interface. To begin this process, click Users in the sidebar and then click Users again. The screen will list any user that OpenMediaVault has already imported from your Raspberry Pi. To create a new one, click the plus button and then click Create. On this page, give your user a name and also a password. You can use this page to control most aspects of a Linux user. But for this guide, we will be keeping it simple and just clicking the Save button. Confirm the addition of this new user by clicking Apply and then the Yes button. At this point, we have finished setting up OpenMediaVault on our Raspberry Pi. We can now easily configure our system as a NAS by mounting additional drives and creating more shared folders. As you have seen, OpenMediaVault makes managing a NAS a lot easier. You can create new shares in just a few short clicks, and creating new users is made super easy. Let us now show you OpenMediaVault's shared folders in action by connecting to it with both Ubuntu and Windows. With the File Explorer open on Ubuntu, click Other Locations. On this screen, we can see that Ubuntu has detected our shared drives. As the Raspberry Pi's host name is Raspberry Pi, that's the name it will be under. If you have changed the host name already, then it will be under the name that you set. Double-click this share to begin connecting. On this screen, you can see the shared folder that we set up within OpenMediaVault. Double-click it to connect to the shared folder. As this share isn't public, you will see a screen saying authentication is required. Click Registered User and type in the username and password for the user you created during this tutorial. Once done, click the Connect button. Let's verify this is all working by creating a new empty folder called Hello World. With that confirmed working, let's now connect to the share using Windows. With File Explorer open, use the top address bar to type in // followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi that is running OpenMediaVault. In our case, that is 192.168.0.32. Now fill out the username and password for the user that you created earlier, and then press the OK button to connect. You can see that our Windows PC can also see our shared folder called My Raspberry Pi NAS Share. Opening it up, we can see the Hello World folder we created on Ubuntu. Let's create a new one and call it Hello from Windows and press Enter. Back on Ubuntu, if we now refresh the screen, we should see the Hello from Windows folder. At this point, you have successfully set up OpenMediaVault on your Raspberry Pi and begun setting it up as a NAS. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.